So, kind of funny that we actually need to clear off a Ganondorf mission before we can get to the last six missions that the upper A path has. I mean, we haven't done all the missions in, you know, in the red part of the map yet, but you know.
Well, you know. What can you do?
Yeah, we're not gonna do all the. Like, it's not like we're going to do all the missions up here, like, before anything else, but.
Well, we're not gonna show you all the missions anyway.
No, absolutely not. In any case.
Oh, are we gonna beat up Agatha?
As Ganondorf, yeah.
Yes!
And we can use the trident here for some reason, even though this is the level 3 great swords. I think this is
I
because.
think it's because, you know, the DLC came out much, much later.
Yeah, and they didn't put in a patch for that or something, which is kind of stupid, honestly. And honestly, you should probably be using the trident, but I don't know, you can do this mission with the great sword, so it's not too bad. Little mosquito, yeah, right, whatever.
How dare she calls the great and powerful Ganondorf that?
Yeah, something like that. So this mission kind of starts off with putting a bunch of Manhandle stalks that just focus on your allied base, and it's kind of recommended that you go after them first, honestly, instead of messing around with Dark Agitha here. She's kind of pointless to be fighting, honestly.
Oh, she did care. She did, you know. She did insinuate that the great and powerful Ganondorf.
Well, yeah, but this is Dark Agitha, not the real Agitha, so.
I don't care. Any kind of Agitha needs to die.
Fair.
She insulted the great master.
Right. No, it's more the fact that if you, like, this mission doesn't take too long time, but it's just that you really shouldn't be fighting Dark Agitha, to be honest. Just.
Why are you fighting Dark Agitha?
Because she looked at me funny.
Exactly, that's what I'm talking about!
Yeah, like, I don't think that it's a problem fighting her, but if you find that you don't have enough time to defeat her, then just skip over her. And, oh, oops, that's the wrong item. Oops.
Explosion doesn't kill plants. I've done wrong with during my gardening.
Right, just plant a bunch of bombs in your garden, and you know, it should cut everything down.
Well, the neighbors did complain when I decided to go for a napalm strike, but.
Right. But, yeah, honestly, this mission is pretty basic. It's mostly the fact that the Manhattan, like, you should probably take care of the Manhandle stocks as soon as possible.
ASAP, bitches, get to on that.
Yeah, it's as we said, like, sometimes when Manhandle stocks, they will focus on other bases. But in this particular mission, they focus on the allied base, and that's why that's a big problem.
Usually they will focus on the allied base.
Well, no, honestly, like, mostly, at least, I find at least, that in most missions, they would just focus on anything else. On, like, you and other bases, until they finally get over to the allied base when all the other bases have been taken over. Not in this mission. So yeah, like, allied bases in your poly almost, like, immediately, well, like, 3 minutes in, I think. I don't remember the time parts. I don't remember like exactly what times in the missions I do stuff.
Yeah.
But yeah, this bumbling is.
Although you did say you did give me some accurate times for one mission yesterday.
Yeah, well.
I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah. It's coming. But yeah. So after you defeat the first captain, a group of moblins appear that you can recruit, so that's nice.
Sweet.
And then you can go right
over. They see the might of Ganondorf, and they're just like, yeah, I go with him.
Yeah, like, oh you know, yeah, all my other moblin buddies are trying to fight this guy. Yeah, screw that, we're not gonna do that.
They try to evolve. These moblins don't know what's best for them. So the only way to show them what's right is to kill them, so they will learn in the future. To never cross Ganondorf.
Yeah, like, wasn't that I think it was Doomsday's origin story that some guy was just throwing a baby against the wall and then cloned him and then just kept throwing him against the wall until he was the strongest baby.
Yep.
Yeah. Just do that, but with moblins.
That's basically how he, you know, got born. By making superhumans in the future, when we unlock the secret of cloning, we will just do that for every baby. No, it was like, he threw it against the one until it was like almost dead, and then it cloned him, and then kept doing repeating that.
Yeah, like that makes sense. That's how evolution works. Clearly. Comics are fucking brilliant. Never say anything bad about the comics.
Please don't throw your babies at the wall. We don't have cloning abilities yet, people.
Right.
I don't know, if someone does it and then points to this video, I don't want to be responsible for that shit.
Yeah, you're all responsible for your own babies, in any case. So,
and walls.
I believe that moblins are kind of strong against darkness, and that's why you probably, considering that the game lets us use the trident, you should probably be using the trident. But, as I said at the beginning, you can do this with the great swords, obviously. I mean, there is also a versus skill that is specifically against moblins, I believe.
Yeah, but then you have to farm for you know, the weapon to actually pop up, so...
Yeah, and that's sadly the biggest problem with the locked skills, is that you have no real control. Well, you can sort of control it by buying... Like, you can buy the a potion, like a special potion mix that, you know, gives you a bigger chance of getting a certain skill.
Yeah, but it's still an RNG. It's never guaranteed. That's kind of the problem with these kind of types. Like,
yeah, and it only lasts for one mission in any case, so...
It's you know, I understand in certain games where maybe having, you know, something that helps you get something rare help, but it's still a guarantee because... Well, a good example would be Destiny for that case, like getting some of the exotic stuff. You have help that can give you a higher chance of getting it, but because it's not guaranteed, that's because it's it's kind of an MMO in its sense. It's heavily right. Online based. So, but this game, I don't know. Why not give me the chance? Give me like 100% chance. I mean, it's just me playing. Come on, game, throw me some bones right here, like.
Right. Yeah, please make it easier for me, why don't you?
Well, it doesn't have to be super easy, but just like, you know, I mean, make it...
Yeah, but like if...
Make the cost an expense for both material and money if I want to make sure, like, there's a 100% chance.
Yeah, and the biggest problem, obviously, is the whole core of this is the element system, which is just bad in the first place, and I'm glad that they... Hopefully don't bring that back in any other game.
Well, if you ever get a Hyrule Warrior 2.
Well, I mean, if you get a Hyrule Warrior 2, they will probably bring back the element system. I mean, as in other...
Maybe refine
games.
It in that case? Make it more easy?
More
like,
obvious.
Actually... Well, that, or maybe also that certain enemies have an affinity to a certain element, so it's easy to, like... Bombs could be lightning, which means bring a water one, or...
No, that's what I mean, like, make it more obvious, because, like... like, how are you supposed to... For example, you know the Lysalfos? They have the Lysalfos are apparently strong against light, but weak against lightning. How the hell am I supposed to figure that out?
I would actually assume they were water since they can spew fire. I would assume they were
like,
fire.
Yeah, like, I think the Dynolfos, like, the Lysalfos, well, sorry. No, the Dynolfos are strong against light, weak against lightning, apparently. And but the Dynolfos, I think, are weak against water, I think. And even then, I'm not even sure about that. Like, it's just weird. And yeah, so after you defeat all the three marked captains, then a scout captain appears, and you should probably, I mean, you can take care of him. And I'm not sure how big of a threat he actually is, considering that he spawns regular enemies. But I don't know, like, he could also spawn.
Well,
I think he spawns, like, Stallmasters or something, which is...
Well, they are kind of annoying, so...
Yeah, they can be pretty bad.
But where was going? Like, I mean, some enemies are easier to understand, like, or at least I would assume, like, Gorons probably are weak to water since they live in, you know.
Yeah, in a fire mountain.
They live in a volcano, so yeah.
They live in Death Mountain.
But the only time it's obvious is because it's the character's weapons and they're so like, alright, that one is weak to that because it tells you.
Yeah, right.
But you don't want to, I mean, you don't want to fight, Rudo, if you have a fire weapon,
yeah.
She's gonna kick your ass.
Right.
Well, if the AI was competent, then it's it.
Yeah, again, like, we... It's one of these things that we keep coming back to and repeat.
But
that's what I mean. Like, it's worth repeating in a sense, because I feel like this game would be better without that system.
Either without that, or a much more obvious one, or be able to switch between certain elements. At least with Dynasty Wars, they added this weird element that you had, like, it was Heaven, Dragon, and Man. And it was still the same weapon, but it's just that one was stronger against another type. But since you could switch between two weapons, you either could neutralize it so it's even, or have the advantage.
Yeah, but you wouldn't be weak to it.
No, well, you could be if you were stupid to have the same, you know, type. The game even actually tells you that, oh, you have the same type of, you know, you have two weapons that are at the same type of, that is man. You should probably change that so you don't get, you know, your ass kicked if you meet someone that is strong against it.
Yeah, right. So you can't have choices, basically. So
yeah, so, I mean, yeah, so they could have done that instead of a game like having, you know, maybe, you know, wisdom, power, and courage.
So that's why it works. But in this game, it doesn't work.
No, of course not. I'm just saying, like...
Yeah, I mean, I was trying to figure out how to...
Instead of actually have elements, like... Sure, you can attack to still have, you know, fiery, but, you know, they could be better with the Triforce of Power, or Wisdom, or Courage, and then, you know, Power beats Wisdom, or Wisdom beats Courage, Courage beats Power, and stuff like that. So you have still have the triangle, like, you know.
Yeah, like, it's just mostly the fact that, most characters don't have multiple weapons, and even the multiple characters that have multiple weapons, they can't switch, and a match takes at least 15 minutes.
No, but I would say that if they had that, then you could still have the switch weapon mechanics, you know?
Yeah, right.
It's not that it's that hard, but you cannot have, you know, it would actually be a bit more fun also, because then, sure, some characters doesn't have multiple weapons, wouldn't be able to switch, like, to a different weapons. Like, Impa could switch between her Naginata or her, bigger sword, if she wants to. I mean, that would be kind of... Think of the combos you could actually do with that.
Yeah. That would be pretty cool. Maybe for... they're not gonna do it. Maybe for if they ever make Hyrule Warriors 2, which they probably won't.
The Pokemon just port it. If the rumors are true, then they're just going to port over, you know, Legends to...
Which I'm completely fine.
NX. Oh, I'm fine with that, too. I mean, yeah. It would be easy to record.
Yeah, honestly. But yeah, final thoughts
also
on this
the
mission.
Also, according to rumors, NX is about to come out soon, so...
May 2017, I think.
I need to start saving up.
Yeah. Or don't. I'm going to wait and see what happens with that. So we get the source.
I bought the Wii U during. Okay, I actually did not buy the Wii U during its actual launch. I waited a couple months.
Yeah, I did, and I regret it.
I don't have any games, but the games I have are, you know.
In any case, that's fine. This skull shell actually means that we have 50 skull shell pieces, so yay.
I never fucking had 50.
So what this means is that we have, as the game told us, it means that we have full access to all of the apothecary in the bazaar. So let's go and take a look at all the skills that you can. Well, all the potions. All the apothecary.
Oh, look at all the characters we're probably never going to show you guys.
I'm going to show them off, don't worry. But yeah, all the mixtures that you can buy here, so.
Weapon ranks, weapon stars.
It's honestly like the last Scotia level. The last Scotia level, all it unlocks is like. I don't know. All the. All these gold rank skills. So. For example, the Versus Skill 1 requires bronze materials, but the Versus Skill 2 requires gold materials. Honestly, like, at the time, like, when you need to buy those skills, you probably want the gold materials for other things. And when you don't need gold materials as much anymore, then you don't really need that skill.
It's kind of like a weird, like, you know, double-edged sword there, like, The game says, like, use a couple of gold to have a higher chance of getting gold.
Yeah, it's just odd, honestly.
What are we doing here?
Well, you mentioned last video that... kind of wanted to show off the Great Fairy and what happens when the Great Fairy fights bosses. And, you know, I was also kind of interested in that. Because...
Is it actually something unique?
That's kind of...
Well, we're gonna see.
Yeah. So, yeah, here we have King Dodongo, for example. So, well, first of all, her item usage arc is still the same as Link would normally have it. Because in this case, it's from her niece, instead of, like, how where you think it would be. So, for example, all the other characters throw the bombs above their heads. Obviously, that wouldn't work with Great Fairy, because her head is literally above everyone. It's literally, like, 5 meters above everyone else.
You know, I need to say something that I didn't notice when we showed off the Great Fairy up until now.
Mm-hmm.
What's with the ass shot?
Yeah.
Holy shit, Colony Drop with the moon!
I mean, to be fair, I'm using the... I am using the Great Forest Fairy, and I don't know if it stands out a bit more, but oh well. So yeah, that is the usual one for, well, mostly all the bosses, I think, uses that same takedown.
Oh, yeah.
So that's, well, I mean, like, some weapons have different ones between the bosses, but not the Great Fairy. So yeah, as you can see, it's very weird item usage with the Great Fairy. Especially the boomerang. Like, it makes sense that it should be that low, obviously, because that's where Link normally would be. It just looks weird on the Great Fairy. But yeah, when I saw the hookshot, I just thought, wait, what about Argorok? Because, you know, there's a small cutscene when you use it against Argorok, and as it turns out, they were lazy. She has summons a fairy to do her work for them. And against bosses, I usually use her third combo, the one where she drops a bunch of bombs. If you get in the right position, then you can drop a bunch of bombs, because it's semi-random. Well, no, it is not random at all. It seems random, but it's like, it's actually, it's the same, the bombs always drop in the same position, basically.
Mm.
So, yeah, that's hopefully...
Now we know how that looks.
Funny enough, actually, because of all the invisibility frames that the Great Fairy has, she's actually a perfect counter against Imprisoned.
Oh my god, yes, fucking right.
Yeah, so you have to, like, go right in between them and just to use, like, her... either her Leviathan combo or her bomb-dropping combo.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah, that's, so... Speaking of... So, anyway, back to what we were actually doing. Let's play Ghirahim. Right, so...
So, I see someone... Rupees? There are... different color.
Yeah, I realized that I am running out of money, and... and it turns out, Sand's level 3 mission is also coming up very soon. And trust me, the Sand needs to be a pretty high level for his mission.
So, like, we talked about how weak actually Sand is when it comes to attack, even high levels.
Yeah, he does.
Actually, we haven't talked about it, but he is pretty weak. He doesn't deal much damage. He is. Doesn't deal much burst. He does a very, very weak.
It's kind of weird talking about. Like, if you just compare it to other people, at least. It's other characters, rather. Then he's pretty weak in that regard. Like, I'm pretty sure he's weaker than Ghirahim. Actually, I can look it up while this is.
Well, the way we figure out how Ghirahim works makes him actually, I think, a better damage dealer than, you know, Sans is, because of. If you just make sure he doesn't do his long animations, Enders, you can keep dealing out quick bursts very easily.
Hmm.
And with the knife thing, that works well for, you know, bosses or, you know, single heavy targets. It makes sense, you know?
Right. It's more the fact that, the thing about Ghirahim is that he does a lot of... He has, you know, his third combo, and his third combo does a lot of damage, which is very good, obviously.
Yeah,
but like Sand, for example, he's a lot of fun to use, and a lot of his attacks can stun people.
Yeah, I guess that what makes him a bit unique himself, but
He's very good. He's very good stun potential, but he doesn't have very good damage potential, if that makes sense.
The problem lies in that at the end games, it's all about being quick and nimble. Stun doesn't always help, especially since. Most AI characters have this, you know, wave shit that they can do because that.
Yeah.
I mean, of course, if you have, you know, so you can at least propel one stagger, like. But still.
Yeah, we just. Like, that's also why, for example, the Great Fairy, although she's also, like, fun to, like, use once, she also turns out to be a kind of a bad weapon, because she just takes way too long to do any of her attacks. So, but like, but for example, with Ghirahim here, if as long as you combo, as long as you dodge cancel out of his posing combos, like the posing part of his combos, then he's a pretty quick character, and that works.
That's what I'm talking about. Like, by canceling out most of his enders, his final enders.
Yeah.
So like when he does just snap fingers and summon minions, if you spread out cancel on that one, you can just keep relentless and.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like
I'm actually gonna try him out to see how better he is when I get.
Yeah, like against the captains, honestly, I would suggest that you use his first combo, the one where he knocks enemies up into the air towards him, and then does a bunch of slashes. And then while the captain/commander is still in the air, then you work towards his third combo. Which is the one, yeah, like, so go from here, go through the full combo here, and then go right into the third combo, which you can still do as long as they're marked. And and the mark stays around for like 10 seconds, so you have enough time to just
I see what you're talking about, I understand.
Yeah, so.
No, but that's what I mean, that makes him, because I found, the reason why I found him weak was because of
because game is, like, and that's a problem. Another problem with Hyrule Warriors, there's a lot of things that the game doesn't tell you. Like, for example, you know, how exactly combos work and whatnot. Like, Ghirahim is a prime example for this. He's a good character, but there's no chance that the game is actually going to tell you that he's actually a surprisingly good character.
I can't even remember that the game doesn't really give you hints on how, you know, certain mechanics work. It wasn't until later that actually start doing it between loading screens. They added something like. I think the game, although I'm not 100% sure if Legends told you, but it does.
Well, like there's always that blur.
I don't think the game teaches you that you can cancel out of, you know, your combos.
No, I'm pretty sure the game doesn't tell you about dodge canceling at all, actually. I mean, that's kind of a usual thing in most games.
I know, but.
To be honest, but yeah, that's a good tactic. And.
But it's just that, as we talked about in the previous one, is that it shows that dodge canceling can make slow characters unbelievably, you know, viable in late game. Like, Darunia is pretty good, but some of his attacks are pretty slow, but dodging out of them, some of the slow ones, makes you can get a pretty decent amount of damage.
For once, the Hyrule captain that spawned, that the suicidal Hyrule captain that is supposed to die as soon as he spawns, he didn't die. So I want to see. Okay, well, let's see what happens if he survives all the way then instead, and also, you know, get the heart piece, I guess.
Nothing happens.
Yes. You're completely right about that. What you get is that instead of him dying and lowering the morale of your army. What happens is that he doesn't die, he has to run. As soon as he's injured, he'll start moving towards the allied base. And if he reaches the allied base, then congratulations, he's safe for the rest of the mission, I believe. And which means, you know, no morale lowering for your army. Which isn't even a problem, because you can just kill the ICB for the spawns as soon as he's dead. But I digress. There is at least a way to avoid that, I guess.
Well, we don't have much choices but to digress when it comes to these. Well, what is this to talk about now that we're running out of episodes?
Well, I mean, there's the missions themselves, I guess, because some of the later missions are pretty. There is a specific tactic. Like, for example, as you notice in this mission. Oh, yeah, also, I haven't shown off the magic mode for Ghirahim right now. He turns into that weird sword form that he turned into at the end of Skyward Sword.
I think it showed up a bit in the last video of him.
I don't.
The last video he showed up in, at least.
I recall.
Well, you did turn, but we haven't talked about his form, so.
Yeah, I guess. But yeah. So for example, in this mission, the two, like the Wistro and the Stallmaster, the lower Wistro and the Stallmaster, will start moving towards the Allied Keep very quickly, I think. And they will show up in the same spot at once, which can be kind of annoying, but I mean, it wasn't really a problem as you saw in the video. But yeah, so. So here we have Ghirahim fighting against his master, and I guess that's interesting.
Well, the reincarnation of his master.
Well, to be honest, like, here's the thing. Ghirahim actually has a heart piece in the north.
Wow, whiff, man.
Oops. But yeah, so in the keep that's right above us right now, he actually has a heart piece. I didn't know if I would be able to defeat Ganondorf in time if I try to take that heart piece first. Looking back at this footage, I clearly should have gone for it. Because as it turns out, Ganondorf doesn't have a lot of health. Or, well, he's not very strong against Darkness for some reason. So we actually kind of waste him here, which is interesting. Because, you know, it's the king of all evil. You would expect him to be strong against darkness. Or maybe it's just that Ghirahim is, as we mentioned before, strong, I guess.
He is pretty strong, also. He's almost level 50, so...
I mean, that could also be it, honestly. And this isn't a very...
Man, you're comboing left and right, Jesus! All these wombo combos.
Right. I understand how to fully... You scare him, and that's...
Happy feet, wobble combo!
Yeah, it's an eternity, like...
Well, he is kind of happy feet, you know? See, look at the happiness going on there.
Yeah, right.
All the JoJo posting all at the same time.
Mr. Joestar. So, yeah. This is a surprise. Like, this is honestly not the hardest mission. Obviously, it isn't your hardest mission, but again, it's an A rank mission, and you'd expect it to be a bit harder. Well, sorry, not an A rank mission. It's in the upper.
Well, I think it also depends on what weapon it evolves around. We've shown that certain weapons, or we talked about that certain weapons kind of are more bullshit than others.
I mean, yeah, and also the fact that I'm level 49 with Ghirahim. I mean, I guess that also makes sense that he would be strong in that way.
Come on, Ghirahim, you need to. Nah, I give that 2 JoJos out of 5.
Ah, geez, that's bad JoJoing.
That was bad posting, man.
Yeah, but look at that, like 2,200 damage. Oh, hey, and also look, it's a soul edge. I mean, kind of, I guess. There is an eye at that sword, and I mean, I guess that makes it the soul edge.
Transcendent stories. Stories eternally retold.
Don't start.
Man, I haven't played Soul Calibur in forever.